Hi, today I'm going to show you how to draw this nice figure that you see on the right. In Dan Ingle's video about small talk, this is usually called mandala. And you will see it's not difficult to build it. So to clarify the process, let's start by deleting all the lines. So you see we start with some points on a circle, equally spaced, and what we are going to do is to connect a single point with all the others. Let's see it. Okay. Let's do it with another point, a nearby point. Good. Now we could do by hand for all the remaining points, but I prefer to show it the computer building it alone. So let's see it. Very slowly, the figures start to come. And it is quite impressive to observe how such an easy mechanism can produce such a beautiful figure. Okay, now that we have seen the idea of how the mandala is built, we can go on and see the details. Well, so let's clear, as we did before, the lines, but also all these dots, and let's delete also the circle. Let's start from scratch completely. So let's build our figure. We start by taking a circle. Ensure yourself that create textual reference is checked. Then you can drag the circle into the workspace, and you get a reference to the circle. So we call that object C. I press Ctrl D to evaluate a region. Now let's resize it. Not big enough. Okay, let's define center, radius, and color of the circle. That's it. Let's say that the number of sides is 24. You can change it to whatever number you want. Now, we make a list, an empty list for now. Let's look at it. Vertices list. And we do Ctrl Shift E. You see? An order collection empty. Good. Now let's fill it. Let's fill it with the coordinates of the points that we want on the circle. Ctrl D. Let's go to see it. Ctrl Shift I. And you see all the points have been computed. Now, a little explanation on the way these points have been computed. You may remember from your trigonometry classes that if you have a circle of radius 1 with center in the origin, then its x and y coordinates are simply cos alpha sin alpha, where alpha is this angle. But if the circle is a bit larger, let's say it has radius r, then these are the new coordinates that you simply multiply by r. If then the circle is displaced out of the origin, then the formula for its position is this one. X equal x0, here it's x0, plus r, that's the radius of the circle, that multiply cos alpha. The same for y. So, what I've wrote here corresponds to that formula. One thing to observe though, if you see these numbers are here before, because of course usually we think of angles in degrees, but most often programming languages define trigonometric functions in radians, so we need to translate them. Good, now that we have the list of points computed, we want to draw those green dots, and we execute this block. Let's do it. Okay, so let's see briefly what it does. This is interesting. So we define a new list, empty, and now we say for all vertices, that is the thing that we computed, positions that we have computed before, let's go to see them again. For each one of these elements, do what? Do a circle, put it into the world, that is this gray area. Its size of this circle is 15, 15, it means more or less radius 15, let's say in pixel. The center of the circle is that coordinate, and add the circle to this list that we have created here. This list is useful because later we may want to delete all this stuff in a single shot. Okay, let's prepare a list for the lines that connect the circles. And now let's connect, in this case, we say VC is a single vertex with index 12. It could be whatever. Okay. Now, for all vertices that are in the list, vertices list, build a line from the vertex VC to the vertex V. That is the iterating vertex, okay? Open the line in world and add the line to the list of temporary lines. Again, because we may want to delete all of them in a shot in the future. So let's see. Let's run it and that's it. Now we do the same thing, but for all the vertices. So from 1 to the number of sides, that means the number of vertices, do the same thing that we did before. The only thing that is a little bit unusual is this stuff. This line is for make is to make quick wait for 500 milliseconds, that is half a second. And this line is to force the update of the world before waiting. If you don't put this line, you will not see the draw coming out interactively. It will be all drawn at the end. So let's run it. Control D. This is our nice animation. Let's wait for it to finish. Then clear all the lines, so you see we iterate on this line. Let's see what's inside this variable. You see, inside this variable there is a polygon morph. Polygon morph, which is in our case a line. For each one of them you do what? You delete it. And then we go to delete all the dots, same stuff as before. And when we have finished, we delete the circle. And so we complete our exercise. Now to you, the task of trying to draw this thing with more vertices, less vertices. You could try to change color. And also it may be interesting to try to draw those points with turtle geometry instead of using trigonometry and Cartesian geometry. So for this evening, that's all. Goodbye.